Hello dear student, in this video we will learn the concept of web form that will be used in ASP.NET. So ASP.NET, this you know, it is an application framework and it is used to develop the web applications or the websites, and it is a part of Visual Studio. With the help of Visual Studio IDE, you can develop ASP.NET web applications. For developing web application with the help of ASP.NET technology, there are different ways that you can use to develop any application. For that, for example, ASP.NET MVC, ASP.NET Web Pages, ASP.NET SPA, that is a single page application, and another one, web forms. So for your curriculum, you are having a web form for designing a web application. Now, what exactly web form? Web form, it is a combination of HTML pages, then HTML code, source code, then server code, and client side scripting that you can write. Server controls. Server controls includes web control, but web controls, just like for making UI, you required text fields, then radio buttons, then suppose image button for action, event handling. So these web server controls are present within these web forms. So web form will be having a UI part. Through the UI, user it is going to interact with the server, and the request will be sent through the UI. For example, with the help of button, it will be sent. At the back end of the button, the code will be written, and to write a code, we should know the language such as the C#, J#, F# or the VB.NET. And with the help of that, we will write that code within the button, and this will be sent. It will trigger that request to the server, and server will respond to the browser with the help of HTML. So in this way, web form, it is just a combination of HTML page, C# page, ASPX page. We will see into the Visual Studio how exactly it looks. This is in just diagrammatic view that you will understand. So the browser, that is a client, it is sending a request. So when you run your program, ASP.NET program, then it will be open into the browser. And through the browser, the client is giving the request. For example, simple example, suppose I have one field as in a roll number and one button. And through the roll number, suppose I want a date mark sheet of your last semester. So roll number, I will put that roll number into the text field, and then I will click on the button. So this is a client request will be sent by the browser. So it will be sent to the web server. Now, which web server we are using right now? IIS server. So it will send to the IIS server. Visual Studio, it is having a by default server that is in an IIS Express. So this IIS Express will take that request, that is a roll number, and it will be sent for the next processing to the data server, application server. Now this application server will be having that your connectivity with your database, and it will retrieve that particular data. For that, you have to write a code for retrieving a data that you know. You have to fetch a query, SQL query or any another language query. So web form role is there. So web form will take that input, and it will pass that input to the appropriate data servers. Now these web forms, which are different languages required at the back end, so C# you can use, so VB, that is the oldest one, J#, F# you can use. And this web form, it is also containing this web controls that we are going to learn in the next module. Now, what exactly the ASP.NET web form are? It is in a compatible with any of the browsers. So, what are the features of web forms are? It is compatible with any browser. You can run it on a mobile device. So, and then it is compatible with any language. But it is supported by this .NET CLR. So, CLR, it is used to compile your programming language. So then any language means you can take example of C#, VB.NET or J#. Then built on .NET framework that you know, that is one of the basic feature of web form. Now what exactly it offers or it contains, I told you that is a UI part, and at the back end you can even change the HTML and the CSS code also. Even you can write the JavaScript code between that. Then you have to write the server control coding part. So for that you can use the C# language. We are going to use C# language for that. So these are the some waveform that it will offers for developer to develop application. Now, what are the features of waveform? The first one is a server control. It is a famous example, or you can say it is an important one, important concept for your ASP.NET. So server controls that different toolbox will be get provided, such as the text box, button, labels, then making the grids controls, then images, inserting an images. So you can design your web page with the help of this toolbox. These are the server controls. Master page, that will be your main page. So single master page. So first that page will run, and then after that your next pages that you have to link with your within your website. Then working with data. So this ASP webform, you can connect these webforms with this ADO.NET, ADO, OLDB, with the databases. So we can retrieve a data, we can store data, we can display the data. Membership, that you can use basic login features. Just at one example, that we can connect to Facebook, Twitter, or the live authentication system. Client script and client framework. So we can embed that code, client scripting code, just like a JavaScript code within that particular ASP.NET web forms. So it is supporting for client scripting also. So it is supporting the routing, state management, that you can preserve the data of whatever you are sending or you are getting the request from the client to the server in the form of the cookies or in the form of the session. So that is a state management. Security, platforms, it is also supporting for the security. So there are so many threats are there in the internet, just like a spoofing, repudiation, information disclosure. All these things you have learned within information security subject. So I'm not going to repeat it, that there are different threats are available, and to tackle with that threat, in a web form you can design, you can add, or you can add some features of security within that. Performance, yeah, it is having a good performance, but when we compare with MVC, model view control, so compared to the MVC, it is a slow one. Means this waveform, it is a slow one. Internationalization, it is supporting for the different languages. ASP.NET waveform, right now we are preferring the English language, but suppose I want to switch to any another Japanese or Spanish, then it is possible to switch to that particular languages. Okay, it is supporting debugging and error handling, and deployment and hosting is possible. So ASP.NET webforms, it is doing all the operations, whatever required for the web application. Now, another thing that we have to decide whether we should go with the MVC or we should go with the webforms. MVC, it is the latest one, new one. So you can try for the MVC also. Both are the good one. Webform, it is the oldest one. So, and MVC, it is something different concept, model view control concept. So it depends on your knowledge. You can work on it, but the final aim is that you have to develop the web application, so output will be the same. Okay, so this is about the advantages of using webform. So just you can go through it. Now the main point from your curriculum, that how to create a webform. So for creating a webform, first we have to open our Solution Explorer, and there we have to right click and then add a new item. I will show over here. So this is a Visual Studio. In this Visual Studio, where is the Solution Explorer? At the right corner, this is a Solution Explorer. Left side you are having a Server Explorer and Toolbox. Right side, Solution Explorer, right top corner, and below that, properties. So we have to go to Solution Explorer. Then this is my project web application 2. Right click on it. Go to the add. In add, go to the new item. Here you will find different items. It is loading right now. Which one we required? Web form. So I will take a web form. Say add. Now this web form, it is added, webform2.aspx. Now you can see what is in a web form and its extension. Its extension is a ASPX, extension of ASP.NET. Now it is a combination of just we learned, that is HTML, UI part and server control part, server control coding part. Now what is that? So this is in a design view. Right now we are in the design view. So here we can add anything from toolbox. These are the server controls. So toolbox containing server controls. Suppose I am taking text box. So the text box is here. So this text box, after that, suppose I want to add a button. Okay, here is a button. So this button, when I click enter, so I one page you can see here, CS page, that is a C sharp page has been added. So this one is okay. This is a button. This is webform one, sorry, webform two just we have created. So when I double click on the button, automatically C sharp, that is a server coding page, will be get added. So here in the button click, we have to add a code in a C sharp. What action should be taken place? Whether I want to redirect to some another page or what action we want to perform on that. So that code we will write within this C sharp page. So you can see here, this is the design part. If I go to the source part, then you will see this is an HTML source code. So as just I have dragged and dropped the text box and the button over here, at the back end automatically that code will be generated. You can see here ASP text box with the ID number run at server. As this web form, it is a feature that it is sending the request to the server, and then server it is responding the request back. That's why it is a slow one. So you can see here run at by default it is a server one. Another one, button, I drag a button, drop there, and that's why button one created, on click button one, text one. So this is your HTML backend code will be get automatically generated. You can see here page language C sharp, then auto event write up through, then code behind. You can see the code behind means this at the back end, actually at the server side, what will be get executed? This one, C sharp code will be get executed. And what it is inheriting? It is inheriting web application 2, that is your main application, and web form 2, it is just a class. So this is your web form. Okay, so this is a path that how exactly you can add a new item. Go to Solution Explorer, add new item, and then among that take that web form. You can write down, even you can rename that web form, and then you will see this is a picture that from where just we have added the web form. This is a UI part, user interface part, and this is a source code part. And for run that particular web page, just I will click on this IIS Express. So this webform2.aspx will run. It will take some time. So just right now we haven't written any code behind it. So just one text box will appear and with one button. but no action will have taken place. So for